into the fire. Oh, jeez. So what do we do now? We lost our objective, Morden.
Major Rossi.
Marco here.
Oh, missed you at last. Since we were cut off all of a sudden, I have been worried. Think about you.
I've been underground all this time. I just got back to the surface.
Is that so? If you go underground again, tell me first. I told you I was worried sick. I tried to reach you thousands of times. All I got was static, but I can't get it out of my mind. It was like...
Always the fucky little chatterbox, aren't you?
What? That voice has gotta be... Eri?
That's right.
Why? The Major's colleague?
We just met up with each other. I was underground too.
Is that so? By the way, listen up, Eri. You two really know how to abuse personnel. Material Division's half-staffed, running around all alone, Major Rossi's got me gathering intel, and since they're developing new prototypes at the lab, the scientists have me walking the dog!
Well, before we take any more action, let's go over the intel we've got so far.
Good idea. And stay in sequence, will you?
It looks like it all started when Morden got his hands on the Alator.
So what is this Alator, anyway?
I guess you could call it the unrivaled jewel of scientific achievement.
So if he's got the Alator technology, he can make weapons far more advanced than anything we've got.
Yep, and he acquired it 10 years ago while he was still a general with a government army. It seems that the discovery of this Alator reignited Morden's ambitions. But he wasn't able to use the power of the Alator to its full potential.
And as a result of that, we've been able to suppress Morden's coup d'etat.
Yep, but at the same time, Morden found a new backer. The founder of Sermay Ogma Enterprises and present CEO, Mr. Ogma. He not only provided Morden with military funds, but their technology succeeded in analyzing the Alator.
And Morden, obtaining this mighty military power, was able to wipe out the army. Let's get going, Eri. We don't have time to stand around here.
Hold on. What are you saying we should do? Do you plan to walk from here?
Look over there.
What? What's that shaking?
We Peregrine Falcons are always prepared. We've got points like this all over the world.
Wow, that is nice!
There's another one hidden over there. We'll use these to attack Morden's stronghold.
Now? Are you mad? We should pull back and regroup!
If we regroup our firepower, that'll give Morden the same opportunity. And what sort of strength will the army have if we try to regroup anyway? The more time we take, the less of an advantage we'll have.
But it's just the two of us. Attacking the enemy base with no battle plan, that's just plain suicide.
What are you talking about? Skill, experience, and luck are all on our side.
Oh, jeez. Give me a break. You're just insane.
I know it's a crazy plan. I can't make you come with me, so I guess I'll go it alone from here on in.
Are you expecting me to run away while you march into the Maw of Death? That's a dumber plan than the other one. All right, you can add my skill, experience, and luck to your battle plan.
Thanks, you're the best. I knew I could count on you.
Mission 6, start!
Mission complete!
Some awesome weapon.
So now you understand. Now you know just how strong Morden's forces are.
Yep, I know it all too well.
So what do you say we pull back and rethink our strategy?
No way. What I understand is that we've got to defeat Morden fast. He's an opponent we're able to beat.
So I guess you're saying there's no stopping now.
Yes, there is. We're stopping Morden and his goons. Now let's move out!
You're great!